My earliest memory of being amazed by science was visiting the LA Children's Museum and having my shadow captured on the wall. So as a tribute to that moment, I'm going to show you how to build your own shadow wall, and then we're going to talk about the science behind what makes stuff actually glow, and then we're going to take it to the next level with a ridiculously talented artist buddy of mine. But first, I wanted to see if kids today think these glow walls are as cool as I once did, so we invited some family friends over for a party. When the dads came in, the results were as expected. So here's how you make it.
For projecting the light, the standard camera flash works great. The higher the wattage, the better. Or you could sort of paint it with like a UV flashlight or this blue laser. A red laser doesn't work, and a normal flashlight doesn't work as well either, and we'll learn why in a second. For the wall, I found there were two options. You could either use glow-in-the-dark paint, or I found a place online that sells rolls of glow-in-the-dark vinyl sheets. You can put it directly on the wall, or I use some half-inch sheetrock just to make it portable. And depending on how much of the wall you want to cover, it'll probably cost you somewhere between 50 and maybe 200 bucks. I put all the links in the description with even more details. So I asked my super talented friend Jason Ballman to come over and see what he could do with the glow wall. But before we get to that, let's quickly talk about the science behind why stuff glows.
Our eyes can actually see electromagnetic waves from 400 to 700 nanometers in length, and our brain distinguishes them as colors. So 400 is blue, and then up to 700 nanometers is red. But as soon as a wavelength gets out of this band, we can't see it anymore. And on the short wavelength side, we have ultraviolet, or UV, and on the longer wavelength side, we have infrared, or IR. And if you keep going on the shorter wavelength side, eventually you get things like X-rays. If you keep going on the long wavelength side, eventually you get things like Wi-Fi, and even radio waves, which can be the length of entire cities.
When you look at fluorescent colors, something special is happening. Electrons in fluorescent materials get excited to a higher energy state by ultraviolet light that we can't see. And then when they return to their low energy state, they emit visible light that we can see. This is why they seem to glow in the sun or under a black light.
Invisible UV light comes in, and then visible light comes out,
which is why they seem brighter. More light is actually hitting your eyes than if they weren't fluorescent. Glow-in-the-dark stuff is just a special case of fluorescence called phosphorescence. The only difference is that instead of electrons getting excited and then releasing that energy right away, phosphorescent materials have electrons that get excited, but then they get trapped in this high energy state, and it takes them a while to release the energy and get back to their original state. and they'll give back the same total light. It's just over a long period of time, which is why they glow dim. Okay, now to Jason. I also found that if you displayed an image with a projector, you could burn that image into the wall. And if you displayed it on your phone, you could sort of make a light stamp.